Condition Red Star Rising has been initiated.
Prophet, if you can get eyes on that intel, you might be able to find out who tortured me.
Found it.
What's it say?
Nothing. It's redacted.
System X.
We placed blockers on your dopamine receptor. Your mind would be protected. Without them, exposure to my mind would consume you.
The dopamine blockers are cleared.
You did this to me.
Archangel begins the most aggressive protocol set available. Red Star Rising. Total. Orbital. Annihilation.
Why can't Cell stay out of my goddamn way?
I need to get everyone out to the perimeter.
You're wasting your time.
I have to save as many lives as I can.
No, it won't matter. It's not gonna be like Ling Shan. Archangel has a massive global energy store. They feed all that power back into the Alpha Ceph, and it'll punch one hell of a hole in the Earth. There'll be no Earth left.
So what can we do?
Connect to a Ceph Mindcarrier. If I can get inside their heads, maybe I can reverse the ring and put them all back to sleep. There's no Ceph threat. Cell will call off Archangel.
You're going to link yourself to the Ceph? Prophet, you struggled to resist their influence even when your mind was protected. We've turned those safeties off now. That means the nanites in your suit are free. That means they can transform into anything, any form imaginable. You could actually become a Ceph.
That's a risk I'm willing to take.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Crysis Remastered. Today we will be playing level 5 Red Star Rising. And we start by taking the collectibles above, the Datapad and the Nanosuit Upgrade. Then we move to the first fight of the game against aliens, but first there is another Nanosuit Upgrade right here. And yeah, against aliens, as I said in my previous video, I recommend using bow and arrow, because it's easy.
You're never gonna make it. They're gonna nuke the whole city. You're all gonna die.
Okay, so yeah, let's start off. This fight is going to be easy. With bow and arrow. As you can see, it's just one shot kill. Then we pick up the pinch rifle because we would use it soon after we interact with the cell structure. First we pick up everything. Okay, now we can interact with the structure.
Bend the knee and join me.
They aren't attacking you. My god. They think you're Ceph.
No. Not just Ceph. They think I'm the Alpha Ceph.
I am the Alpha Ceph.
Prophet! Prophet! It's too dangerous. You're losing yourself to the Ceph. Prophet!
No! No, I'm okay. I'm alright. I feel the hive mind. It's so powerful. That's it. Their thoughts and the power, it's all the same thing. If I can only...
Oh shit, not good.
Get out of there, Prophet!
Okay, so in this fight we have maximum energy and we don't take any damage, so yeah. So far, now we have this stronger enemy, but it's not a problem. I'm going to take the other pinch rifle that's left here. And we go and fight back.
Rocket to patch!
Wow, easy done. So now we can move to the next section, and before that we have a black box on the right side down here roughly, before we go into the open area where we have five cells.
Prophet,
and enemies.
We need to link up ASAP. The situation is out of control.
It didn't work, but the Ceph hive mind is pure energy. If I let them in a little more, I can take that power for myself.
Prophet, come back to me and listen. I've got more details on Archangel. It's already in transfer orbit. It could be on us within the hour. We also know cells evacuated everywhere but a single facility about 5 clicks from here. It must be a command point for the satellite. Get me inside and we can shut Archangel down together. Are you with me on this, soldier?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so in this fight we have aliens and cells, and on the far side you can see we have turrets. The Ceph, we cannot attack them because they are the ones that hide the stalkers, but it's fine. Let's kill cells. Okay, seems like we cannot do much from here. So in this building on the left we will also have some collectibles. We have a datapad, a propaganda poster. And then we will have a nanosuit upgrade. Cool. So the datapad is here on the left. Let's kill this last enemy. The propaganda poster is here, you can see it, it's this one. But then we have the nanosuit upgrade right here on the back, but careful because it's protected by a turret, so we have to disable that turret first. Pretty easy, now we can collect everything. Now we go back, we fight the aliens that we need to fight. So we have also two cell operatives. Nope. I want the...
yeah, boy.
Mounted weapon. Because it's easy to deal with aliens. Disable the turret, hopefully fast.
Surprise, motherfucker!
surprise, motherfucker.
Hello?
Okay, so it was not as easy as
surprise, motherfucker.
I thought. Because enemies apparently like this spot. So we can disable the last turret here. Before anything happens. Okay, I don't know if it's really worth bringing the weapon because we only have three aliens to fight again, but okay, we can try. As you can see, they are here. More aliens spawning, so I didn't bother too much. Let's move on to the next section.
Prophet, Claire, my unit, the Ceph disabled our APC. Can you? We need help, Prophet. I don't think this is a survivable situation.
Hang in there. 5 minutes, okay? Just 5 more minutes.
Okay, so we take the datapad here. There's also a nanosuit upgrade here. And then we can take the dune buggy and move towards Claire and Delta. So I just recommend driving through. Don't stop for any reason because, yeah, it's better, in my opinion. So as soon as we arrive, we will have to fight some cell operatives. It's not going to be super difficult, but yeah, be prepared. There are just more than two, they will spawn. Okay. I don't know where the other arrow went, but okay. Okay, it's far up, up there. Okay, we got rid of most cell operatives. let's move on. From now on, it's just nothing particular. It will be a cutscene before we move to the next part of the level.
New wave! From the north! It's hopeless! We're never getting out of here!
Listen up! You will keep that negative horse shit off my airways, or I will personally send you to fight the Ceph yourself as a one-man front line. Do you understand me?
No, he's right. This is hopeless.
It's not hopeless. The one-man army is joining you. Let's go.
Romeo Actual, this is Romeo One. We have a vulture prepped and ready for evac. Over.
Michael! You came back!
Romeo Actual, this is Romeo One. Please observe standard radio protocol on this channel. Over.
Whatever you say, Romeo One. Over.
Okay, so Psycho is back and helping us, and we have a new Dune Buggy part to do before taking the Dune Buggy.
That you could do.
There's a black box, and then again, like we did in the first part, I just recommend ignoring every enemy and reach the second part. Or the end of the level, let's say, because yeah, otherwise just risk losing health and resources for no reason. Then as soon as we reach, let's say, at the open area, we will find a plant that we can use for our purposes. Wow, they hit me. Let's move away from here. That was terribly executed by me.
Romeo 1, we are clear and ready for takeoff.
Okay, so yeah. Here on the left we will find the tank and we can use that for our purposes. Especially considering that the tank has infinite ammo. Let's go.
Warning. Seven threats detected. Security lockdown in effect.
We destroyed the pinger. Hopefully. We haven't even destroyed the heavy tank. Okay, now it seems that it's gone. At least the pinger is gone. Okie dokie. Then we have more enemies over there. Then some enemies probably over here. And then our objective is actually on here, where I'm showing right now, where there are some turrets, as you can see. So it's better if we destroy them. Should not be working. Then we have some cell, as you can see. visor. Let's check. Okay, we have a datapad over here. And we should have a black box over here somewhere. Okay, it's behind there. Nice. Okay, we can move up there here. Open the gate. And go back to our town. Okay. We can go. I recommend using the tank because also there will be another tank here to fight and a couple of aliens. Nothing too dramatic, let's say, but okay.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
Okay. And now we can simply go to the end of the part, let's say, of this section. Remember to drop off the tank before this light slope, otherwise, yeah, it just explodes, I don't know why. And anyway, the... from here on you have to walk. Because you will find that the street is blocked. Yep, the path is blocked by another tank. Okay, so, yeah, we have cells fighting aliens.
Prophet, landing zone is hot. There's an external generator powering the air defenses. Can you put a shell through it? Over.
I'll see what I can do.
So I do not really recommend staying here because it doesn't help a lot if you're going to do the secondary objective. I lost my scarf, which is over there. So let's go take the zipline and do our secondary objective, which is on the left here. Let's go. We have to fight some aliens and some cells. Be prepared.
Status.
Confused. He's not making a lot of sense. Don't think he knows where he is or who we are. But physically he's fine. I think he's shell-shocked. He was holed up dead center of a Ceph hot zone. No idea how he survived that onslaught.
Okay, so that one is one of the heaviest units. Let's use the explosive arrows. And if that's sufficient, we go back to our normal arrows. Okay, we have some enemies to fight. And a turret to take care of. but it's not gonna stop us. Let's disable the mines first. And we have a turret on our right, which is the light blue one. Line of sight obscured. Better if we disable it first so that it can help us fight some of the cells remaining. Let's be accurate. Okay, sweet. And here we can defeat. The last two cells that are left, and collect also a nanosuit upgrade that we have here. Easy done. Oh, actually, that's the third one that he was unaware. Okay. No. Okay. I was super accurate until now, and now that I have no pressure. I made a mistake. Okay. No issue. Let's collect the nanosuit upgrade, it's right here. We have to destroy everything over there, so let's collect some C4. And
fuck you!
Aerial defense is down. Free to land.
Copy that. Now make your way to the control station. Hurry up. Lift should still be functional. Over.
We need to collect the last arrow. Now, I will take this with me, because then we will have to fight some aliens, and this weapon is quite strong. Nothing really to take with us, so let's go. We're almost close to the end of the level, let's say. We have to enter the gate of this cell structure, and then it's almost done. We have to fight only some aliens here and some cells once we are inside, and then we should be good. Okay, so we have Scorchers, and we have one heavy alien, heavy equipped, heavy armored, I don't know how you want to call it. Let's move without being noticed.
Putting the veto down. Over.
Get back some energy. Tag any enemies that have not been tagged. Okay. We could also do something different. We could take this with us. Put it on the...
Open! Chicago with...
And have absolutely no effect. Actually, it had some effect, so it should die right now. Exactly, perfect. Now we can take the heavy machine gun back and defeat the Scorchers. Shouldn't be a problem. couple of them exploded, as you could see. Okay, pretty easy. Now we can move inside. Okay, let's not screw these up now that we are at the end. So we are in a good spot. Now up there we have only a turret, but we will take care of that later because we don't need to go over there right now. It's so easy. What are you doing? Okay, that was an interesting grenade, to say the least. Okay, now let's go over here. There shouldn't be anything. But I will show you anyway. Okay. Now we can move towards, let's say, where we actually need to go, which is in that direction, where we have probably some more cell operatives, as we heard from the voices. I mean, there's just one at least. We also have some collectibles to take care of, which are over there. In this
Archangel ETA
container.
5 minutes.
Okay. Let's disable the turret. Okay, some more cells, I guess, or not? Not really. Doesn't seem so. Okay, now we can... activate the bridge, then some cell operatives will spawn. But it's going to be easy for us. Exactly.
I need you to access that terminal.
Accessing.
Emergency procedures in progress. All remaining cell operatives must evacuate to subterranean containment facility 5 Epsilon 9.
Stop it.
Charge. About 5%. Just under the threshold for a chain reaction with Ceph energy. We got lucky. Very lucky.
Is that all he's got?
Projecting stage 3 simulation.
Stage 3?
I needed you. I needed all of you to help me escape my cell prison. My children were mindless while I slept. Shutting down Archangel was the last thing I needed from you, and for that I must thank you.
What? What are you talking about? Rash.
Projecting stage 3 simulation.
The third and final stage.
The beam. It's powering. Oh my god. It's an Einstein-Rosen bridge. A goddamn wormhole to the M33 galaxy.
And there's something big coming through.
Back in the safe house, when I couldn't get a read on you, you said it was because you were the suit's creator. But that's not it, is it? How long has it been going on? Extending your life with nanotech, with Ceph DNA. Do you have any idea what you've become? You were battling the Ceph hive mind, just like me. Except, you lost. They absorbed you. And now you're one of them.
You have something, Prophet. Something the Ceph will never have. Oh, understand. Get out.
get a bit sticky!
Prophet. You need to see this.
Stage 3 is the final and most deadly element of the Ceph colonization strategy. If met with significant and persistent resistance, a Ceph incursion force will seek to open an Einstein-Rosen bridge direct to the heart of its parent galaxy. From there, Ceph Overhives will deploy their dedicated warrior caste to obliterate any and all obstructions.
We've only seen a fraction of what the Ceph can do. This is an extinction-level event. The Alpha Ceph will keep powering that beam until their entire invasion force is through. We have to shut it.
Claire! Claire!
See you in the next episode.